Yo guys, what's up? Welcome to a new video. Today I'm going to show you how I create my own track covers. And we are on the page Pixabay right here, and this is where I mostly search for my background pictures for the track covers. Another page is Pexels. There are also some nice pictures, but most of the time I use Pixabay. Let me show you for a second one of my track covers I created by myself. So yeah, this picture right here, for example, is a track cover I created by myself. I don't know where I have the original picture, the original background picture right here, but yeah, this is the cover. Sometimes I also use own pictures I created, like this one here. But yeah, on that one I used, for example, on that one too, I used a picture from Pixabay. And yes, then let's search for a picture right here. Let's use this one. So yeah, the pictures are free for commercial use on this page right here. So you can use it for any kind of commercial projects. And let's save it right here, and then let's take it and first put it in Lightroom. I always put the pictures first into Lightroom. So let's click import, because you have to change them a little bit. You can't use them 100% like it is for a commercial project, and the Lightroom crashed. So yeah, you can't use them like the original one. You have to change them a little bit. I don't know if it's already enough if you just put a text in them, or if you have to change them a little bit with a filter or somehow. But yeah, to be safe, I always change them up, not only with a text, but also with color correction and other stuff, because some of them are also not that edited. They are in standard or raw, so I mess around with them a little bit. So for example, with the temperature, we can use this right here a little bit. Yeah, but let's leave it in the middle to make it to make it look a little bit more creative. You can also mess around with the tone right here. I'm going to put it like that. Then you can make it more darker or brighter, to put it like this, and put the contrast on 51. And all of that is like trial and error a little bit. So I try out what fits the best, what looks nice, what fits to the track. Sometimes I listen to the track in the background and create the cover to the track like that. So let's put the white a little bit higher and the black. And yeah, you just have to try out a little bit. Structure, we put a little bit up. Clarity, a little bit up. And I don't know how it's called in English, but let's put that one a little bit up, because I think that could look really nice. Or we also could put a little bit down. Yeah, let's put it like that. And then we can also map the dynamics and the saturation a little bit. Then there are also other things right here. For example, we can put the red colors more. We can put it more up, orange, yellow, green, and so on. But I'm going to leave it like that now, and then I am going to export it. So I exported it now. We have all my pictures, and then let's go into Photoshop. I'm going to pick it out now and load it in. So yeah, first let's create a new project. I always use 1000 x 1000. Sometimes I use 1200, but for that one I will use 1000. Then let's load the picture in. So there we got the picture, and then let's adjust the size of it now. So yeah, let's put it like this. That looks really nice. And then I'm going to take my logo now. So there we got my logo, and I decided to pick the black one because the picture is really bright, so you can see the logo better. But I'm just going to put it in the top right corner, really small. And yeah, we could also use the white one. Let's look what fits better. And then, but then we have to use it with the, with shadows. But I don't know what fits better right here. The shadow, ah, that looks also really nice. I'm not sure which one to use. I think I'm going to use the white one right here with the shadow, because it also looks really cool. Let's put it in the top right corner like that. And yeah, so we got it like this now. Let's put the shadow a little bit down. Yeah, let's do it like this. This looks really cool in my opinion. So then let's put in the track name. I'm just going to call it track name now. And we are also going to put this in white, like this, and then put some shadow in there. Here we can do it a little bit harder, and I think that also looks already looks really nice. So, but let's take another font. Let's search for a cool font right here. Maybe autumn. It's a little bit too fat in my opinion. Can use this one maybe. Yeah, this is cool, I think. And then let's put it into the middle. And that already looks really cool. Maybe we could use it as a cover. In my case, I would use it like that already, because it looks really cool. Let's pick a name for it to make it yeah, so it looks a little bit more authentic. Yeah, let's just take lakes or something like that and put it in the middle again. And that's already a really nice track cover in my opinion. Yeah, then you can add some other things, like for example frames, or like underline the text a little bit like that. Let's just do that right here. Then paint this with white, and also put the shadow on that one. So we underlined it now, which makes it a little bit more the person focused a little bit more on the track name with that. But these are also some essentials you can do to that. Also, we can put a frame. Let's do that. So here I got a frame. I just got it from Google, just Google frame.png or something like that. And I'm edited the same way I did with the font, but let's put the shadow a little bit down, and then we got it like this. And yeah, this looks even better now, and I'm going to save it for maybe a future project which is called Lakes maybe. You also can put the font on in this corner or this or in this, but I decided to do it like this now. And so I'm satisfied with this one. I hope you like it too, and I hope I could help you with the with this tutorial. And then thanks for watching, guys, and goodbye till next video.